welcome to this week's debate of Goa Ahead. And the issue that we are deliberating this week is, can there be a non-BJP, non-Congress alliance in the next assembly election, and whether such an alliance can be a formidable force. I have three eminent panelists joining me. First, I have senior lawyer and senior political analyst from Goa, Cleofat Almeida Khutino. Cleofat Bab, welcome. Then I am joined by MGP's leader, Ketan Bhatikar. And last but definitely not the least, Goa convener of the Aam Aadmi Party, Rahul Mamre. Cleofat Bab, I'll start with you. Sudhin Dhavlekar, leader of MGP, proposed this. He said that you cannot rely on Congress, you cannot rely on BJP. Other parties need to come together, credible parties need to come together and form a force that can take on the BJP. Do you see such a proposition as a reliable proposition, formidable proposition?
As far as I look at it, MGP is thinking of contesting about, even their president has said they are serious about 12-6. MGP has been forming governments with the Congress party, with BJP. And their history is to be a minor partner in any of the alliances to be formed. I don't consider seriously the proposition of Mr. Sudhin Dhavlekar. In any case, your proposition for today's debate, whether there can be a non-Congress, non-BJP alliance, according to me, the only other small player is the Goa Forward Party, which is seeking an alliance with the Congress party. So the question should boil down to whether AAP can raise that bar of theirs, whether it could be a non-Congress, non-BJP challenge. And according to me, they had put their best foot forward in the last assembly elections. They had number of people who did quite well, at least in South Goa. In North Goa, only in one constituency, they did substantially well, that is Aldona. And in South Goa, they did well in Kortali, Nuve, Kurtorim, Benauli, Kurshore. Now, most of the people, and Mapsa, they also did quite well. But most of the people who did well at that time are not there with them. I feel that the Congress party has suffered a huge dent with some people leaving, particularly persons like Babu Kavlekar. Other people may not matter much, but still it is a dent. But AAP also has had a huge dent with persons like Royla, who scored very well in Benauli, person like Olencio Simoes, who did very well in Kortali, persons like Shraddha Thalap, who did well in Mapsa. There are people in Nuve and Dr. Gudino, their person in Kurtori, Edwin Vaz, are no longer active. Their person in Kepe, who did very well, one João Fernandes advocate, is also not there with them. He has joined the Congress party. So I feel that AAP has also have a huge dent with people like their South Goa candidate for parliamentary elections, Elvis, who was their convener, Pradeep Padgaonkar, Rodney, Dr. Oscar, no longer with them. I feel that we are almost at the same position at 2019, because in the year 2019, the BJP was doing extremely badly under the leadership of Parsekar. Currently, the leadership of Pramod Sawant is facing the same position, particularly because of the COVID management. And I look at this election as almost the same position of 2017 with a weakened Congress. But I somehow feel that MG this time may do substantially well in some of the areas because of the so-called split. I would not say split, but various groupism in the BJP I feel would act to the
may benefit MGP.
Of MG party. So I expect them to increase their tally slightly ahead.
Okay.
But I don't consider this non-BJP, non-Congress alliance
a formidable option. A formidable option.
Not at all.
Not at all. Rahul Mamre, respond to that. First, let me two questions. Number one, Cleophas Bab made a very nice point that Aam Aadmi Party today is as dented as Congress. Number two, with the current position of AAP, you are trying to project yourself as a serious player. So do you envisage any understanding alliance which is a non-Congress, non-BJP alliance, and whether your party is open for such an option?
I did hear Dr. Cleophas on that. He said various names about who have rather dented the party as a party. But he deliberately failed, perhaps, I don't know for what reasons, to mention that it was our candidate from Benalim who won the ZDP seat. It was our candidate from Navelim who was shot by victory by just 400 votes. So we have seen the people of Goa, have seen the growth of AAP. One more slight correction I had to make. Dr. Budino, which you mentioned from UN, is still with the Aam Aadmi Party and is heading the doctor's cell of the Aam Aadmi Party. And people in political party come and go itself. They had their own reasons to leave the party, and we are thankful. We always said we are thankful to who have left the party. And in fact, the people who have left the party then are now responding and they seek to join the party again. Okay, that's one part of it. Secondly, I would like to say that people of Goa have seen the BJP, they have seen the Congress government for also so many years now. They have done with it now. Either way, both of them have the politics of the same thing, politics of corruption, politics of nepotism. And people of Goa have seen through it. Whereas Aam Aadmi Party is now a credible alternative. Last election in 2017, we didn't have much track record of governance in the Delhi government now. People of Goa have seen, have been following the governance in Delhi. And wherever I go, people notably say, your government in Delhi is doing a remarkable work. We are focusing that work. And now the entirely focus of me and my team and the entire party is to reaching out to people of Goa, making Goans a part of Aam Aadmi Party, understanding the issues and reaching out to them. So our ration campaign, which we are doing, is one of that. When none of the political parties go, forget the government, none of the political parties in Goa realize the issues, realize the problem. It is only Aam Aadmi Party who is coming
out. Rahul, the question is whether your party right now is in a mindset to look at options of alliance, which is a non-Congress, non-BJP alliance, and are you guys open for it?
So we are right now, Pramod Bhav, we are just focusing on reaching out to people. We are not talking about alliance. We are not thinking about it at this moment. Our focus is mainly to reach out to people, make Goenkar part of our lives, and making Aam Aadmi part of them. So that's the whole objective of Aam Aadmi Party at this moment.
You are saying right now that is what you are looking at, but you are not closing your options.
Right now, we are not given a thought to it at all. We are just focusing on Goan people, working out with them.
Yeah.
Okay. Pramod, I would like to add to Rahul one small thing. He spoke about Benauling and he spoke about Naveli. In Benauli, in the last assembly elections, also they did very well. Their candidate Royla came second, polling over 4,000 votes. That was the highest they could come in the last assembly elections. Okay. One. And that Royla, their candidate, is now in the Congress party.
Mr.
Mamre may tell us that it is the votes. It is the votes of their party. But finally, we will find it is the person also matters. Like we will find Dayanand Sopte won, but in the neighboring Babu Azgaonkar won. So I don't think it is these persons also matter.
Okay.
Like,
so I'll come to you, Rahul.
I'll take Ketan and then I'll come to you. I know there are many finer details of this that we need to deliberate upon. I'll take Ketan and I'll come to Ketan. Sudhin Bab made that proposition. He said that Goa needs a alliance which is non-Congress, non-BJP. How is your party looking at it and how practical it is?
See, at this moment, party has decided to meet on July 15th. This decision will be completely taken by the committee. But I still feel if you all get together, then things will change. These coming elections, you will see one thing, that a lot of people are joining MGP. MGP will make a difference and we need to go ahead together, as he has said, because people are fed up of these two parties. So I agree with what my leader says.
No, Ketan, the point is, can that be a formidable alliance, not just an alliance? Eventually, what you are proposing is taking on a election behemoth like BJP. Can that happen? MGP with other smaller forces, can you do that? Is that a practical proposition?
When smaller forces get together, you form a larger force. So at this moment, keeping your egos aside, not waiting for the last moment to get into any alliance power, because that's where you fight, and you have always seen what happens with Congress. They don't know who is the candidate even on the last day of the filling of the form. So that's why my leader has taken us. No, very good point that we need to go ahead now. We need to think about it within this July, August, so that we know which seat who is there, which seat who can do what, and that's how you form an opposition against the ruling government.
Before I go to Cleophat Bab, Rahul, how is your party looking at it? Means, do you want to contest 40 seats, or your primary objective is to ensure that there is a non-BJP government in the state? How is your party strategically looking at it?
So our party is looking out to resolve the issues of Goan people, basically. We are trying to contest all 40 seats, and we'll be contesting there. Okay, our leader, Deputy CM Manish Sisodia, when he came to Goa, he said the same thing, that we'll be contesting all 40 seats. So we are trying at the moment, Pramod, our objective is to making Goan a part of Aam Aadmi Party. Reaching out to them, that's where you look at it. Alliance, completely we're not thinking about it at this moment. So right now, the focus is entirely to raise people issue, like small issue, like the issue which happened yesterday night at JMC. The Gadas of Goan people are completely demolished out there, right? They're trying to make a living out of that, two times of meal. But that also, this government is completely not able to digest. That's the whole issue.
Cleophat Bab, when you listen to all these voices, do you envisage an absolute split in anti-BJP vote right now? And it is a clear-cut advantage BJP.
To some extent, you are right. But I find that, it all depends upon how you position yourself. Because finally, somehow I believe that there is no third place in politics. Yes. You have to win or you have to lose. And that is what we will find exactly happened in many constituencies. Except some say in Benawali last time, where there was no third place at all. Even where Aam Aadmi Party put their best candidates, I have the entire list with me. In most cases, they could not cross, say, 1,000 votes with some of the best candidates, because at that time, it was seen that the Congress Party was a challenger. Now, if they can position themselves as challenger, then so be it. But look at the position from 2017 to 2019. In the North Goa parliamentary seat, Nota gets 7,000 votes, while AAP gets about 4,000 votes. Now, and their best candidate, the convener of the party, who is also the parliamentary candidate, gets something like 20,000 votes in the entire South Goa. Now, in such a position, how much can you increase your vote percentage? I am not at all saying that AAP should not contest 46. They are entitled to contest 46. They are entitled to position themselves as a Goa party. But for me, they are not looking at winning this election. They are positioning themselves as an alternative.
Yeah. They are Rahul, respond to that.
Yeah, so Cleophat Bab again, mentions about the lady in Benawali. He says that she got back the highest votes in the 2017 elections, right? But he conveniently forgets to mention that the same candidate, the same lady who contested in the ZP election, was defeated by a 26-year-old candidate, Hansel, in the Benawali ZP elections. So the party has seen the growth now, and it's growing. The trajectory, if you see now, from the ZP polls, he says, right, that last year, 2017, we didn't have a track record, as I said earlier also. Now we have got a formidable track record of governance, which is proved by the mandate which people of Delhi have given to Aam Aadmi Party. First, it was 67 seats. The next, the election thereafter, it was 62 seats. So now with the formidable track record of our party, of our governance, people are reposing faith in us. And that's very evident in the ZP polls which I have held here. We got votes not only in South Goa, we got equivalent good votes in North Goa as well. So now, as the election progresses, the campaigns are being rolled out, people are understanding what Aam Aadmi Party would be providing to them.
One more thing, Pramod, small thing. See, the highest ever vote percentage change has happened in West Bengal from the last, not this assembly election, from the last assembly election to parliament elections. Hmm. And that was the highest in India. It was 11% in favor of BJP. Hmm. Now, that's the highest in India. Now, I don't know how much higher than 11% can AAP expect in Goa.
Okay. Secondly, before I go to Ketan, Cleofat Bab, you said that you feel that MGP might fare better. And
I am of that opinion that it would see right. They were three last time. Hmm. I expect them to somewhere be around five this time.
Hmm. But you in no way you see that these parties coming together can pose a challenge to the BJP.
Coming together will not be a. I don't see coming together. Hmm. If at all there could be some coming together, it could be some coming together by BJP MGP. Before or after elections, MGP maybe with the Congress party after elections, certainly not before elections.
Yeah.
MGP maybe with BJP after election, depending upon the numbers. But looking at AAP's position, particularly because elections are there in Punjab, I don't see AAP having any alliance with anybody because for them, that is a bigger place where they will be playing.
Okay.
Absolutely not, Pramod Bab.
Yeah.
So it's not about, because of Punjab, Goa cannot go for alliance.
Hmm.
I mean, people of Goa are making a resounding statement. They have seen Congress, they have seen BJP guys.
Hmm.
In fact, in the last mandate was for Congress, which the BJP stole away. Because why? Congress sold it away to them.
Hmm.
So now people of Goa are smart enough. They don't want to commit the same mistakes. And now AAP also is coming as a formidable force. And I'm sure people of Goa have seen this track record for the last 5 years.
So that Rahul point taken, that I'll go to Ketan and ask the same question, what Cleofat Bab said, that pre-poll, at least everybody believes, Ketan, that MGP might not ally with Congress, might not ally with BJP, but in a post-poll scenario, considering your track record, everybody feels that you may go anywhere. So why should people trust you?
This is not about the trust, or it is not about the pre or post-poll.
Hmm.
Best is give us the power and then we stand by and we work the way Bausaheb Andorkar did.
Hmm.
So MGP is going this time. 12 seats are confirmed. We are going with 12 seats. I am thankful to Cleofat Bab ki dane paanch seat. He said that we will win 5 seats at least this time.
Hmm.
So we are going with 12 seats. We are looking at plus 6 at this moment to get into around 18 seats.
Yeah.
So let's see if we can go around into those 18 seats and go ahead with it. I think that we might form. And now again about the post-poll. See, you need to run a government. Let me be very frank. I am in Ponda. I am working for the people of Ponda. I would support those who support my work.
Mm.
It's as simple as that for me. Finally, work needs to be done. And it's not that ki, tomorrow I would ask Mr. Mamre also, tomorrow if Aam Aadmi wins some seats, it's going to stay in opposition for 5 years? I don't think so. It is going to join hands with someone. In Delhi, Kejriwal had said that he would never join hands with any party, but he has joined hands with Congress. So finally, you need to run the government. You cannot burden people with elections now and then and again and again. So it's not
only
about MGP.
You are saying give clear mandate.
It's not about MGP.
You are saying give clear mandate.
Pramod, by contesting 12 seats, by contesting 12 seats on talking of 12 candidates, how can they talk of a mandate?
Yeah.
Cleofat Bab, I clearly said 12 seats are confirmed at this moment of time. And within some days, till July 15th or might be August, we are going ahead with plus 6 more. And if there is no alliance talks, you never know. You might see MGP going with at least 30 to 35 seats.
Hmm.
But that will be a decision taken by the central committee. And
okay,
not our.
Okay. Cleofat Bab, then that brings me to the very crucial question about why this talk has started. The talk has started because all the smaller parties, at least till now, are very distrustful of the Congress with their experience in the past, not making prior commitments, not making the alliance.
There is only one
prior.
Smaller party, that is a Goa Forward Party. I don't think there is any other party.
Hmm.
Pramod?
Yeah.
There is only one party, Goa Forward Party.
No, even MGP is very clearly saying that we cannot trust Congress at this point of time, in spite of being thrown out by the BJP, because Congress is not ready to make any prior commitments. They are not taking any calls on leadership. They are not taking any calls on alliance. They are not even saying whether they want to or they do not want to. So with this kind of a situation, do you think that distrust of the Congress is at the root cause behind this discussion?
As far as your leadership issue is concerned, I think that hardly matters. I look at leadership issue currently as, you know, elections are around and the person who will sign that Form B is the most powerful person. You know, in NCP once, that mine owner, who is that?
Raful
was Hale. Having the NCP B signing form authority,
Raful though
Hale. He was not the party.
Yeah.
So basically, I would say the leadership hardly matters because finally the candidate should be decided in Delhi.
Hmm.
So that way, leadership does not matter. What matters possibly is declaration of a chief ministerial candidate, not the party president at all, because once the candidates are decided in Delhi, the president of the party hardly matters.
Hmm.
But as far as the mistrust is concerned, I think there is bound to be mistrust, particularly taking into consideration what happened in 2017. So parties will have to be careful. See, throughout the country, parties are splitting. Congress has been losing the MLAs at least in the past 7 years. Look at Bengal today. People are shifting back to Trinamool after Trinamool wins. So somehow our MLAs are such that they shift where power is. So I don't blame the party, but at the same time, they will have to take steps as far as this mistrust issue is concerned. But in our state, I don't think there is any mistrust simply because Congress cannot have a direct alliance with the MJ party, taking into consideration their constituencies. AAP has said they are not going to be an alliance. And the Goa Forward, which has three MLAs in the assembly, talks of an alliance.
Do you think Congress should go for alliance with Goa Forward?
My personal view is the same view which came up in your program last time. I would say that if Goa Forward merges with the Congress party, the credibility of Goa Forward leaders and the Congress also shall be better. So they would be in a better position to position themselves as being together, because people somehow have not liked what happened at 2017. And the memories of 2017 are still there, despite the fact that the 10 members, 10 shifted, Subhash Shirodkar shifted, Sopte shifted, despite all that 2017 is still being remembered. So I would say if they merge, it would be much better. The same view came before your program last week, and I endorse that view.
Rahul, final comments. Do you think with this kind of positioning that MGP is taking, if there is no alliance, we'll contest 30 seats? You are saying we are going to contest 40 seats. Congress is saying they are going to contest 35 to 40 seats. Do you think even Goa Forward is saying they are going to contest around 10 to 12 seats? So do you think with this positioning right now, if there is no consolidation, it is clear-cut advantage BJP simply because there is an absolute split in an anti-BJP vote share?
I beg to differ, Pramod, on that. It's not a consolidation of anti-BJP vote share. I mean, BJP is not in advantage position at all, because the anger and the angst of the people of Goa is against the Congress, simply because they sold a mandate which was given to them. For the BJP, for the misgovernance they have done, for not protecting the interests of Goa, be it on various issues. Okay, where it mattered, the BJP government has failed out to reach the people of Goa. Now for the alliance part, it's for the other party which you mentioned to take the individual call. As far as AAP is concerned, we are working on the ground. Our focus and objective is clearly to reach out to people of Goa. Tell them what governance we have done,
As Cleophas Bab said, that can there be a substantial, and when I say substantial, a vote share shift of probably 15% towards any one political entity when everybody wants to contest all the seats, can there be that kind of a shift, Rahul?
It's not rocket science. When it has happened twice in Delhi, okay, it cannot be ruled out in Goa as well. And Goa being a much smaller state to compare to Delhi, it's much easier to shift the entire votes to a concentrate entire votes against the anti-BJP, anti-Congress forces.
Okay. I'll come to you. Ketan, final comments. Do you feel that the present positioning can only lead to advantage BJP because all of you in your individual constituencies and your individual strongholds, you may win 2-3 seats or 4-5 seats, but eventually you are going to split the anti-BJP vote share across the state?
I would just take 2 points.
Yeah.
One is Congress is responsible for all the mess what is happening. They still don't have a leader. They are still, when the central leader comes, they are still fighting outside their office and they say it's a family issue. And this is the same thing which is going to happen even before the last day of filling the form. This is one thing. So alliance is out of the question. Second, no, if MGP will go more than 30 seats this time, I'm telling you, we are going to be a big factor when it comes to BJP's vote share. Because those BJP's vote share has a complete draft shift to MGP. And MGP...
What you are essentially saying, Ketan, is that forget about the anti-BJP vote share. MGP is capable of splitting the BJP vote share.
101%, which I've been always telling, if MGP goes on full on, I am telling you, we have proved it in Ponda also at ZP election. People have their faith in Sudhindra Hoikar. If he comes all open this time and we go all around,
okay.
It would be...
You are saying you can split BJP vote share. Cleofa, yes. The final comments with that kind of confidence that we can split BJP vote share.
See,
do you think things are hanging in balance or it is advantage BJP?
See, I feel finally in an alliance. The question is whether it is chemistry or maths.
Yeah.
I don't find, at least in Goa, votes shifting from one side to another. Like MG votes may not shift to Congress. Congress vote may not shift to MGP, but between BJP and MGP, there may be a shift of votes.
Yes.
To some extent, if AAP and Congress comes together, there could be a shift of votes, but that is not going to happen. So since that alliance is not there, I would say in Goa, at least, it would chemistry that would prevail over mathematics, because we don't have a Nitish Kumar, we don't have a Kejriwal, and we don't have a Mamata Banerjee who can dazzle the people like it happened in those states.
Okay.
So Nitish Kumar in 2015, Kejriwal in Delhi, and Mamata Banerjee. We don't have those figures.
On that note, I'm completely out of time. Cleofat Bab, Ketan, Rahul, thanks a lot for joining. It's an interesting 6 months we are going to have. But most important factor is the same thing, that whether, as far as the anti-BJP vote share is concerned, which is growing day by day because of the discomfort and discontent of the people, can it gravitate towards any one option? Cleofat Bab, Ketan, Rahul, thanks a lot for joining. I think the basic question that is going to be in the minds of all the people, can anti-BJP vote share gravitate towards any one political party or any one political alliance? Thanks a lot, everybody, for watching. Keep watching. Go ahead.